I'm a disgruntled Eagles fan ever also.
Hey Disgruntled, what is up? This is going to be a new little series. I've did this for a couple years. I believe it was my junior and senior year of high school, where I would do preview and recaps to each of the Eagles games. But the reason why I stopped doing this is because it became too much work with my college experience, and I just needed time to adjustment, so I kind of faded out my freshman and sophomore year. But even though I still have a lot of workload for this semester, I think I'm going to ramp it up because I'm going to try to keep them 5 minutes under. 5 minutes and under, just a quick synopsis, because I like these short, rapid videos that I create where I can still talk about the Eagles, but it's short enough where it doesn't interfere with my schoolwork and other opportunities that I have with jobs and other outside of school or school-related work. This one's going to be a little bit over because I have a few things to talk about, some Eagles updates, what I did just a couple hours ago, and I'm going to recap the Falcons game. I know I probably shouldn't because you guys are already probably over the Falcons game for a while since it is Saturday night, because I am, at least, but I just wanted to share my thoughts and opinions on the Falcons game, at least, just to get it on camera. So, I'm going to put like a time thing in the beginning of this little recording, just telling you when you can skip to actually the 49ers preview. So this is an Eagles 49ers preview, but before I get to that, I'm going to talk about the Falcons really quick. It's just going to be like a minute at most, or a couple minutes, I should say. Eagles played a phenomenal game against the Falcons. I know, it's just the Falcons, but good teams defeat bad teams this way. Guys wouldn't be talking if it was close and if we would have lost to the Falcons. If we would have lost to the Falcons or gotten close, I feel like we would have gotten a lot more hate towards our way, but we start getting hate saying that it's only the Falcons. Good teams like the Chiefs, Super Bowl caliber teams like the Bucks defeat excuse me about my hiccups. But great teams, Super Bowl running caliber teams, playoff teams destroy bad teams this way. Now, it is still too early, it is still just the first game, and we shouldn't get overhyped, but I feel like we're getting a little bit too much hate coming our way just because it's quote-unquote the Falcons and we need to chill. I still think that we should be getting hyped because we were expected to be worse than the Falcons. We're in the bottom half of the team, and I know Falcons are, their defense is terrible, but still. What I liked about this team, or about this past game, is that we ran the ball. Ertz got to 7 different wide receivers. Wait, let me just double check that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 different receivers and running backs. He's spreading the ball around, which is good. He's seeing the open field, which is excellent. And the biggest concern that we had going into this is his completion percentage, but I think he was a 71%, 27 for 35. He eliminated that option. He got 3 touchdowns. He didn't turn the ball over, 264 yards, which is excellent. Another key thing is that we ran the ball. Jalen Hurts, Kenneth Gainwell, and Miles Sanders. We ran the ball a total of, 31 times, a total of 31 times, which is really good. Between Gainwell, Hurts, and Sanders, this is what I like to see. I would want Sanders to get a little bit more reps. He went 15 carries, 74 yards. I would like to see him get the ball a little bit more, but I really like that dynamic of Sanders and Gainwell. I've been really, really hot on Gainwell's, or I've been really ecstatic on Gainwell, Kenneth Gainwell, due to the fact he's just, from what I've seen in the highlights, what I've seen in the preseason, he's a great multi-back receiving and running the ball as shown this past game. He went 9 for 37 yards and a touchdown for a 4.1 average, which is great for a rookie. He got his first touchdown of his entire career. And with this duality, I think it'll give Sanders a more relaxed feel during the games where he doesn't have to put the entire game on his back. And I feel like Gainwell can step up when needed on that third possession, like Sproles did, and some of like Corey Clement, even like LeGarrette Blount sometimes. He was kind of the main back. Gainwell is a great third down back, or late down backs, where we need to punch it in. Devontae Smith, he played an awesome game. I mean, this is the kind of game that we expected a first round player to play. He had 6 receptions, 71 yards, and a touchdown. That touchdown, first catch, first touchdown of the season for him was a beautiful play. No one was expecting it. I personally wasn't expecting it. I think it was a third and four, And that is the same exact spot where he caught his game-winning touchdown at Alabama in the national championship a couple years ago, which is really exciting to see. He played really well. Jalen Reagor played really well. I was very cautious about him because he wasn't really doing good in the regular season or in the preseason, and he didn't really have a good regular season last year. Third or for a first-round draft pick, we were comparing him to Justin Jefferson. He got picked by the Vikings the next pick, and most Eagle fans are probably going to say we wanted Justin Jefferson then Jalen Reagor. Personally, I still would want Justin Jefferson over Jalen Reagor as of now, but Jalen Reagor is starting to prove himself a little bit more. 6 receptions, 49 yards, and a touchdown. Dallas Goedert game, 4 receptions, 42 yards, and a touchdown. Great pass connection for that touchdown. That was a great pass. Zach Ertz had only 2 receptions, 34 yards. But still, very good. We need to sign Dallas Goedert right now because I really want him. I love how the offense played this game. They were consistent the entire game. The offensive line needs to clean up their game a little bit with offensive or false starts with Isaac Samalu and some penalties on Lane Johnson as well. We need to clean that up. But other than that, I feel like we had a pretty much flawless game, because if you can score 30 plus points in a game, in an NFL game, that's pretty good. Falcons side, or on our defense side, we only contained Matt Ryan to 164 yards, 0 touchdowns, 21 of 35 attempts. The only thing that I was a little concerned about is that we did allow them to have over 100 yards rushing. Most of that came in the first half, which we kind of eliminated the second half. We didn't really allow their offense to run much in the second half, but I want to improve on that. We only allowed Ridley, though. We had the first off, we're number one in pass offense as of now. We only allowed 164 yards, but we stopped Calvin Ridley to 5 receptions, 51 yards, and Kyle Pitts with 4 receptions, 31 yards. Kyle Pitts is not that big of a accomplishment because he is still a rookie and he's still getting adjusted to the NFL, but it is a big accomplishment that we only allowed Ridley to 5 receptions to 51 yards. But the defense weren't really going the two drives, but they found their groove and they were able to stop them, which is what I want. That's the perfect game. Allow the offense to get going and then just stall them the rest of the game, or just stall them the entire game. But it's almost impossible for you to do that. I was a little nervous the first two drives, but the defense fixed itself, got 3 total sacks. Javion Hargrave got 2 sacks total. I want to see more turnovers, though. If we can get the turnovers, then that can help win us games late as well. And overall, I'm really happy about where the Eagles are as of now, because this was a solid game. Even though it was against the Falcons, I still think it was a really good game. This is what we needed to do to prove that we're a good team, is to beat teams by a large margin like this. Let's get to the 49ers Eagles preview. This is what the video is about. This is about San Francisco 49ers and Philadelphia Eagles. Now, I think we can beat them. My prediction, I sent someone this, I forget who it was. I sent that the Eagles will win 30-17, and that is a pretty big stretch even for 49ers. 49ers is a lot better team than the Falcons are. But let me just read you. This is the most recent update from Friday of the San Francisco injury report. This is the injury report. So out is linebacker Dre Greenlaw with groin. Doubtful is Siege. Cornerback Emmanuel Mosley. Questionable defensive tackle Ark Armstead. Linebacker Marcel Harris. Defensive tackle Javion Kinlaw. Reserves has injured offensive tackle Sean Coleman. Cornerback Devontae Harris. Wide receiver Jalen Hurd. Defensive lineman Marcy Harris. Wide receiver Richie James. Running back Raheem Mercer. Offensive line Justin Skirt. Cornerback Jason Vermont. Reserves has physically unable to perform list. Running back Jeff Wilson. Defensive back Travis Moore. Reserves has suspended by commissioner. Defensive tackle Jordan Willis. That was a mouthful. I'm probably just going to screenshot that and put it up as I'm reading it. What I'm saying is that they are a very, very injury prone team, and I feel bad for them because they've been injury prone for the last since the Super Bowl. Eagles won the Super Bowl. Ever since then, the 49ers have been very unhealthy, except for when they actually made it to the Super Bowl. That was probably the most healthy that I've ever been in. Probably then they were a little bit injured as well. But what I'm saying is that they're a very injured team. And I'm going to read, I got this information from Eagles Galaxy about kind of the matchups and kind of the new signings from the 49ers and what we're kind of dealing with the wide receiver core against their cornerbacks. The 49ers CBs, Josh Norman signed 12 days ago. Dre Kirkpatrick signed 4 days ago. Ambry Thomas, rookie third round pick. Damian Laird, rookie, fifth-round pick. Kervion Williams, 7-year vet. Eagles receivers should be chomping at the bits. The Eagles and Jalen Hurts, this is the time to play Eagles players and start Jalen Hurts. Please start them. I'm starting Devontae Smith. This is going to be a killing if played correctly because we have 49ers, a couple guys who just got signed, and I'm dealing with a bunch of rookies and this only, like, veteran is a 7-year veteran. We should dominate this game. This should be a freaking blowout. It should not be close at all. If this is a close game, I don't want it. This should be a blowout on paper. Nick Bosa, I am concerned about though. 49ers still has a dangerous defensive line with Nick Bosa and linebackers. I mean, a couple of their linebackers did get injured, but that line is, we really need to focus on that defensive line. But I believe our offensive line, as of now, is a lot better than their defensive line. Not a lot better, but I feel it's better. Because when healthy, the Eagles' offensive line is a top 5 offensive line in the league. When healthy, we've shown that last year when they weren't healthy, they did shit. But they are healthy. They had a great game against the Falcons. And I feel like they can have a great game against the 49ers. Most of the 49ers' defense, as I just stated, is injured. But I think that Smith, Rager, Watkins, Goddard, Ertz, Sanders, Gainwell, and Jalen Hurts can destroy this team with passing. If they get going early, there's no stopping them. Just like the Falcons game. The Falcons game, the Eagles got to an early start, could not be stopped. Most of their points did come at the end of that game, but again, once they get going, they cannot get stopped without doing some damage with point-wise and yardage and tying out that defense. Defense side, I'm looking, this is the most challenging part though. We got Debo Samuel, we got Ayuk's, I don't even know what's up with Ayuk because he's not even trying, he didn't really try in the preseason, I don't even know what's up with Ayuk. And we got that dual quarterback with Trey Lance and Garoppolo to watch out, so the defense does have a handful to watch out for, and this is going to be a little curious because we do really bad against rushing quarterbacks, especially Russell Wilson, Patrick Mahomes, the last few times, a couple times we played him. It's just insane. We get carved open time in and time out by running quarterbacks. We just can't find a system to defeat these running quarterbacks. But if we can stop them early, get to the quarterback early, I feel like that's going to set the pace because they do have some injuries on the offense as well with Raheem Mostert. So I don't think they can do much running-wise. Running-wise, I feel like we can stop them early, even though we struggled early in the Falcons game. But I believe that if we can stop the quarterbacks early and the running backs, I feel like this should be such an easy game to win. So what I want to see out of the defense is to get to the quarterback early, stop the run game early, and just force Garoppolo and Trey Lance. Trey Lance and the young quarterback, it's only his second game. I don't know how much he's actually going to play, and I feel like 49ers are using that dual quarterback to their advantage, so it will be kind of hard to see what exactly will happen with that. We gotta watch out for Trey Lance. We gotta stop that early. He's still a young quarterback. Garoppolo is going on the wayside, and I just feel like if we stop them early, then and force them to throw the ball to their receivers, then it's game over. Because if you stop that run game fast, it's literally they can't do anything about it. I want them to stop the run game early. I feel like that's most game plans, stop the run, stop the quarterback, but just try to keep them contained and force them to throw because they're running quarterbacks, and what running quarterbacks do is destroy you running. And then contain Debo Samuel because he had an electric game last game. I think he had like 9 receptions, 189 yards. Let me just look that up real quick because he played a very great game against the Lions, and he had He had 9 receptions, 189 yards, a touchdown. He did have a fumble. You have to contain him because he is the best receiver on that team. But I think Darius Slay and Harris is going to stop them because we have the number one passing offense or passing defense as of now. Our running defense is shit, but stop them early. And this is dub. And Lions, at the end of that game, I know it was kind of garbage time points, but they came close. They were down big against the 49ers last week, but they were coming back. They scored 16 points in the fourth quarter, and I know most of that was garbage time, like I said. The Lions were able to exploit that defense, and I think Lions, of all teams, were able to do that. And I think the Eagles is a lot better team than the Lions, can definitely do that early. 49ers should not have allowed Lions to score that many points, and especially in garbage time. They should have been a blowout, or they should have stalled and just called it quits. So I have the Eagles going 2-0. We did just sign Josh Sweat, 3-year, $26 million guaranteed, $40 million in incentives. He does that, very, very good deal. This is the greatest deal of all time. A really good defensive end for this cheap is very great, very great. We also signed Jordan Mailata. I forget. I think it's 3 years, $100 million. Yeah, it's very great news. Let me just get the exact amount. I don't want him singing. Okay, new deal is worth $64 million. Potential to reach $80 million, including $40 million in guaranteed money. So this is a 4-year contract, very cheap. Again, Howie Roseman is starting to step up to his game. He signed these two players to really great contracts, and hopefully he'll sign Dallas Goedert. I don't know what's taking him for so long to sign Dallas Goedert. Hopefully we can sign Dallas Goedert to a 4-year extension, or to an extension. Hopefully he's a top 15, if not top 10 tight end as of now. So please sign him to some money. Please, Howie Roseman. Howie Roseman is finally making deals, and I feel like he's getting the fan base back into it. He got Zach Ertz back. He's forming this great chemistry between the Eagles players, and I'm just really happy to see that out of him. And he's starting to get the faith back from the fans that were lost earlier with the whole Carson Wentz situation. But Howie Roseman is starting to gain faith in his organization and fan base. So that's very exciting to see. I'm very happy about these two signings. And hopefully Dallas Goedert is next. I'm very happy about that. Last thing I say to wrap this long video up, it's 20 minutes long. I saw the great legend, Brent Celek. I just went to a signing earlier today. I'm going to show a video at the end of this video of us signing. It was me, my dad, and his girlfriend or fiance, his fiance's son Jack, and we went to the Brent Celek sighting in Lancaster. And yeah, we got our sign, we got to meet Brent Celek a little bit. It was kind of like the Nick Foles signing. If you remember that video way back, I posted of Nick Foles signing, go check that out. But it was kind of not really rushed, it was more laid back from the Nick Foles situation, not situation, but signing. But we were able to I got a jersey signed, and they got 2 footballs signed, and we videoed it. But I don't know if you were supposed to video it, and Brent Celek, if he made you mad, because he kind of, not mad, but he kind of looked a little bit annoyed. But Brent Celek, I apologize for that if he made you any bit annoyed, but I think it was just because he was having to deal with a lot of people at once, because there was probably 100 to 200 people there getting their autograph signed, and he was probably having to do that for 2 straight hours, and he wouldn't be pissed at that. But overall, I love the experience. We only had to wait in line for about 45 minutes because we got there early, and it was once he started to sign, it was actually really good. He was doing it fast, and I just love Brent Celek. He's a legend, and I'm so happy. He's an Eagles legend, and I'm so happy that I got my jersey signed. And funny story is that me and Licia, co-host of the Kids with the Forest Parents, we went some thrift store shopping, and I saw this section with a bunch of Eagles jerseys, and I was going through it. I saw McNabb, I saw Vic, and then I came upon this Brent Celek jersey, and it was half off. It was originally like $34. I wasn't planning on getting a jersey because they're all $34. Now $30, $34, $35 is very, very, very good for a jersey, especially McNabb or Vic or Brent Celek. But I just didn't want to spend money at that time. But then I saw Brent Celek's jersey. I saw it was half off. It was only $16. I'm like, that's a steal. I have to get it. I'm not going to be able to get a jersey, especially Brent Celek's jersey, any cheaper. Bought it. Next day, I swear, next day, my dad sends me this Brent Celek signing in Lancaster, and I was so happy going to Lancaster for the weekend or this weekend. I'm like, let's do it. I just got this jersey. It was such a coincidence. It was so weird. We got that jersey signed. It was a great experience. I had a lot of fun. We got some videos with him. My dad asked him about real estate. He answered, but that was really cool. It was a really nice experience. So I got Nick Foles and Brent Celek under my belt, signed things. Awesome. Can't ask Matt much for that. I'm going to go get, probably should show you guys the jersey. I'll go do that now. I'll go get it from my car. I just want to show you guys one more thing. I got my nails painted. Janet painted them for me. I think they look pretty good. I think they look pretty stylish, not gonna lie. I'm gonna be right back. I'm going to go get the jersey. Then I'm going to do my famous thanks for watching thing, and then this video is over. It's 23 minutes long, but it's a lot of information in one.
Okay, here's the jersey. This is the jersey that I got for $16 at the thrift store. And then you can see that I got it signed right there by the legend Brent Celek. This is a signed Brent Celek jersey, and I'm so stoked about it. I love the signings like that.
And the store that we went to is in Rockville, Lititz. It's a new store that just opened, but they do a lot of signings. Memorable ones like Brandon Graham right there. But yeah, it's right in Lancaster. Go check it out. A little plug. And thanks for watching.
Hi. Go Birds!
Hi.
Go ahead, Jack. How's real estate, Brent?
It's on fire, buddy.
Thank you.